fine job blowing that horn, my friend. Thank you so much. And there are the horses coming out now for race number one. First of 11 live, great races on the card today. Race one is about 6 furlongs, Exactor Triactor, $2,000 tag, fillies and mares, 3-year-olds and up. Things off. Number one is Majestic Lass, ridden by Dwight Lewis, Pete and Ernie Dubois own. Pete Dubois trains. Andrew Wright's up on number two, Susano, Ed Ackerson, and Tom Dixon own. Bob Gwillem, your trainer. And number three is Cosmic Dreams, ridden by Laris Ellen, Cecil Wiest owns. Lyle Magnuson, your trainer. Number four, Lucky After All, Ellie Rutherford owns and trains. Trevor Simpson rides. And number five, Lamford Stewart up on no slip as Bruce Fenton knows. Nelly Peugeot trains. There is your field of five for race number one in 7 minutes. 7 minutes to post. Is the journey. The horses are continuing to load for race one, and they're off. On the inside, Majestic Lass coming up, Susano. Then it is center of the track, Cosmic Dreams, alongside of that, Lucky After All. And back to the back of the pack, it's No Slippers in the early going. Up front, match race is on. Cosmic Dreams on the inside. Lucky After All now moves up and takes over the lead. Susano back in third. In fourth, Majestic Lass. In fifth, it is No Slippers. As they enter the first turn, up front with the lead, Lucky After All is rolling along nicely. But right there, Cosmic Dreams not letting him get away. Susano stalking from third. In fourth, it is Majestic Lass. And trailing No Slippers. Into the straightaway they go with the lead. It is Lucky After All and a quarter mile to go in second. Cosmic Dreams, Susano's rolling along in third. In fourth, Majestic Lass and trailing is No Slippers. As they come into the final turn now, Lucky After All has some company. Cosmic Dreams is right there. Susano back in third. In fourth, it is Majestic Lass. Around the final turn they come, and down the stretch up front now, Cosmic Dreams puts a nose in front. In second, it is on the inside, Lucky After All. Susano coming on the outside, but at the wire, this one is going to belong to Cosmic Dream. Susano, late charge up for second. Three, two, four, one, your top four. 3-2-4-1, the top four. And we'll say congratulations to the winning connections in race one. Number three, Cosmic Dreams, ridden to victory by Laris Ellen. Cecil Wiest owns. Lyle Magnuson, your trainer. And number three, Cosmic Dreams, pays $7.10 to win, $3 place, $2.50 show. show in second, number 2, Cesano, 530 place, 280 show, and number 4, Lucky After All, 280 show. $2 exactor, $29.90, $2 triact, $183.30. Thank you so much. And that is the Call of the Pulse for race number 2, Exactor Triactor Superfacta Wagering. Also kicks off the start of the early pick 3. There's one scratch in this race. Oh, nope, there's not a scratch. Pardon me. And leading off this race 2 post parade, Neville Stevenson is on number 1, Lady S and Laurie Ferguson in Rawlingson Racing Stables own. Laurie Ferguson trains. 2 will be out later. Number 3, My Sweet Sugar. Ron David owns and trains. Philip Clunas the jock. Laris Ellen is on number 4, Street Style. Doug Love owns. Elaine Evers trains. Number 5, Juana Pango Rise Fall Girl. Ed Ackerstrom owns. Bob Gwillam your trainer. Number 6, Lady Chardonnay. Bill and Martin West own, Jill West trains. And number 7, Whose Is Are You? Carlton Malcolm, the jockey. Andrea Pigeot owns, Nellie Pigeot, your trainer. Thing on number 4, Street Style, and number 7, Who Sis Are You? Post, and they're off. On the inside, Lady Essen up alongside Twine String Queen. Center of the track, Street Style. Back from there, coming up now, Lady Chardonnay. On the inside, My Sweet Sugar, also in the hunt. Fall Girl and Trilling in the early going. Who Sis Are You? Up front now with a half mile to go, Lady Essen with the lead. In second place, Street Style. Third on the inside, Twine String Queen. Outside fourth, Lady Chardonnay. Fall Girl is also following up. Back from there, you've got Who Sis Are You? And trailing the field, My Sweet Sugar. End of the straightaway they go. With the lead, it is Lady Essen in second place, Twine String Queen. In third, it is a Freestyle Fall Girl now coming up the inside. To challenge for third, far outside for Lady Chardonnay. On the inside, Who Sis Are You? And trolling the field, My Sweet Sugar. Lady Chardonnay is pulled up. Up front, rolling along nicely now, it is a Lady Essen and Neville Stevenson flying along. Down the stretch they come, it is a Lady Essen in second place, Twine String Queen coming on the outside, Fall Girl. But as they approach the wire, this one belongs to a Lady Essen, 1-2-5. And we'll say congratulations to the winning connections in race 2. Number 1, Lady Essen, ridden to victory by Neville Stevenson. Rawlingson Racing Stables and Laurie Ferguson own. Laurie Ferguson, your trainer. and $14 to win. 650 place, 470 show. In second, number 2, Twine String Queen, 560 place, 480 show. Number 5, Fall Girl, 420 to show. $1 Superfacta pays $949.05. $1 Superfacta, $9.49. $2 Exacta, $43.80. $2 Try, Nobody Had It. 1-2 with all, $59.30. One scratch in race 3, scratch number 6, Sherilyn leaves us with a field of 7. Exactor, Triactor, Superfacta wagering, 6 furlongs in distance. Allowance race, fillies and mares, 3-year-olds and up, non-winners of 3 races lifetime. Number 1 is Red's Early Girl, Wanapango Rise, Mike Gruel owns and trains. Number 2, Discreet Country, Devil Stevenson on board, Lloyd Buffalo owns and trains. Number 3, Parker's Peggy Sue, Tab Young owns, Jess Maneke trains, Lorena Bujol rides. Number 4 is Kiss and Alley, ridden by Blanford Stewart, Willow May Stables own, Corey Rumsey trains. Number 5, Sweet Wilco, Rocky Mountain Drift Club Stables own, Lyle Magnuson trains, Laris Eleanor Jock. Number 7 is Stitch of Red, Beth Degenhart owns, James Christensen trains, Scott Stir rides. And number 8, Go She's Italian, written by Trevor Simpson, TNC Cattle Company owned, Brad Mead trains. There is your abbreviated field of 7. Going to post in 8 minutes. 8 minutes to post. Starting to load for race 3. And we are loaded. And at the post. And we are at the post. And they're off. On the inside, Red's Early Girl drops back, Discreet County moves up, Parker's Peggy Sue out in the center of the track, out from there is Sweet Wilco far outside, Go She's Italian tucked back in, Kissing Ellie along with Stitch of Red. As they come in front of the grandstand for the first time, a half mile to run, Discreet Country on the inside, on the outside, Parker's Peggy Sue in third place, it's Red's Early Girl, fourth on the outside, Go She's Italian. Fifth coming up now, Sweet Wilco. Back from there is Kissing Ellie and trailing the field, Stitch of Red. Into the straightaway, Discreet Country and Stevenson continue to roll along, but Parker's Peggy Sue and Lorena Bujol have come to join and say hi. On the inside is Sweet Wilco now. Up from there it's Red's Early Girl, also in the fray, Go She's Italian. Back from there to Kissing Ellie along with Stitch. stitch of red. Into the final turn they come. Two-horse battle right now around the final turn and down the stretch, and Discreet Country's on the inside. Parker's Peggy Sue on the outside. Parker, Peggy Sue, and Discreet Country battle it out. Discreet Country and Parker, Peggy Sue as they approach the wire. Boom, it is. Discreet Country hangs on for the victory. And we'll say congratulations to the unofficial winning connections in race three, number two. Discreet Country, ridden to victory by Neville Stevenson. Lloyd Buffalo owns. Floyd Buffalo, your trainer. Here are your prices. Number two, Discreet Country, 380 win, 290 place, 280 show. And second, number three, Parker's Peggy Sue, 510 place, 260 show. And number eight, Go She's Italian, 270 to show. $1 Super Facta pays $900.40. That's $900.40 on a $1 Super Facta. $2 Exacta, $35.40. $2 Try, $50.70. Longs and distance, Exactor, Triactor, Superfacta, Claim Tag 2000, fillies and mares, 3-year-olds and up, non-winners of a race this year. Things off. Philip Clunas is on number one, Come On Fire. Larry Ruth, Corey, and Deshimi Snyder own. Larry Snyder trains. Number two, Why Cry, Cowgirl Up. Tim Moccasin on board. Percy Law owns. Danny Dorchester trains. Carlton Malcolm on number three, Steel Victory. Tyler Harker and Kevin Hill own. Calvin Strandquist, your trainer. Number four is Soul Spinner. Colt Brown owns. Alan Brown trains. Vincent Palmer on board. Number five, Trevor Simpson up on Almost 90. Len Hambley owns. John Poirier trains. Number six, Stormy Indian, Scott Stewart the Jock, Blaine Thorson owns, Dennis Dorchester trains. And number seven, Top Cat Miss, ridden by Andrew Wright, Phil West owns, Bob Willem trains. There's your field of seven. Phillies and Mares going to post in 6 minutes, 6 minutes to post. and Top Cat Miss. Top Cat Miss steps in nicely, and we are loaded. And at the post, and they're off. And on the inside, a little tight there. Come on Fire and Why Cry Cowgirl Up got to see each other firsthand up close and personal. On the outside is Top Cat Miss. Inside from there, Almost 90. And the rail, Why Cry Cowgirl Up. There's your front grouping in the early going. Back and forth it is. Soul Spinner. Fifth on the outside, Stormy Indian. Sixth on the inside, Steel Victory. Trailing the field is Come on Fire in the early going. Rolling along up front now. On the inside, Why Cry Cowgirl Up. Moving up, it's Almost 90 is past that one. Now coming is Top Cat Miss with some run. Moving up into second, three lengths back from there to Soul Spinner. And back from there, Stormy Indian, followed by Steel Victory and trailing the field. Come on, Fire, rolling along now. It's still Almost 90. In second, Why Cry Cowgirl. In third, Top Cat Miss looking to put on a rally. Five lengths back from there to Soul Spinner, along with Steel Victory. Around the final turn they come now, and down the stretch at Almost 90. And Trevor Simpson continue to roll along. Back in second, Why Cry Cowgirl Up. At the wire, it's going to be Almost 90 in a romp. Almost 90 picks it up 5-2-1. And we'll say congratulations to the winning connections in race four, number five, Almost 90. Ridden to victory by Trevor Simpson, Len Hambley owns, John Poirier trains. And here are your prices. Number five, Almost 90, pays $9.50 win, $4 place, $4.40 show. Second, number two, White Cry Cowgirl Up, $3.40 place, $2.90 show. Number one, Come on Fire, $3.10 to show. $2 win three, $138.70 on the win three. $2 exactor, $27.20. $1 superfactor, $798.70 on a $1 superfactor. $1 try, $25.45. And thank you so much. And there is the call to post for race number five, Exactor, Triactor, Superfacta wagering. 6 furlongs in distance, $2,000 tag, fillies and mares, 3-year-olds and up. Non-winners of two races this year. things off, Neville Stevenson is up on number one, Royal Treasure. Don Gibbons, Rod Haynes, your trainer. Number two, Trevor Simpson rides It's a Beautiful Day. John Poirier owns and trains. Number three, Cherie's Report. Bill West owns, Jill West trains. Scott Sturrier, jock. Number four, Miss Nikki J, ridden by Laris Ellen. Jacqueline Smith owns, Lyle Magnuson trains. Number five, Wildcat Appeal. Sharon Stettner owns, Ellen Brown trains. Philip Clunas, the jock. Number six, Lady Poet, ridden by Blanford Stewart. Neil Invick owns, Corey Rumsey trains. Number seven, Pepper Cully, Juana Panguap. Sean Bird Rattler owns and trains. And number eight, Fiddler on a Hoof, Ron Luha Laho is the jock. Dale Shafrick owns and trains. And number five, Wildcat Appeal. Number eight, Fiddler on a Hoof. Our Athol Post. And they're off on the inside, Royal Treasure. Moving up now, It's a Beautiful Day. Alongside of that, you've got Cherie's Report. Center of the track, Miss Nikki J. Up from there, Wildcat Appeal. Far outside, Pepper Cully and Fiddler on a Hoof. Trailing in the early going is Royal Treasure. Up front now with a half mile to go with the lead, It's a Beautiful Day on the outside. Wildcat Appeal, third on the inside, Miss Nikki J. Back from there, you've got Fiddler on a Hoof now on the outside, making a move. Further back from that, it's Pepper Cully on the outside. Inside from there, it's Lady Poet, and trailing is Royal Treasure. Up front now, with a quarter mile to run on a runaway, It's a Beautiful Day, and Trevor Simpson are taking no prisoners. On the inside, Miss Nikki J. On the outside, Wildcat Appeal. Back from there now, making a move, it's Fiddler on a Hoof, also starting to come now. Royal Treasure finally kicks it in. Around the final turn they come with the lead, it's a Beautiful Day. And down the stretch they come, It's a Beautiful Day, heading for home. In second it is Miss Nikki J challenging. It's a Beautiful Day, Miss Nikki J. It's a Beautiful Day, picks it up. 2-4-1. And we'll say congratulations to the winning connections in race five, number two. It's a Beautiful Day, ridden to victory by Trevor Simpson. John Poirier owns and trains. Here race is number 2, It's a Beautiful Day, pays 850 win. 340 plays $3 show in second, number 4, Miss Nikki J. 310 plays 270 show, number 1, Royal Treasure, 340 show. $2 after, 1960, $2 try, $50.50. $1 super factor, 188.70. And thank you so much, and that is the call to post for race number 6, 6 furlongs in distance. Exactor, Triactor, Superfacta wagering, $2,500 claim tag, 3-year-olds and up, field of 8. And Scott Stewart leads things off at number 1, Awesome T, Norm Bowden knows and trains. Number 2, Aikman Joe, Rianne Mahoban owns, Russell Gardepi trains, Tim Moccasin the rider. Number 3 is Wildly Willie Coe, Blanford Stewart up, Sean Calfrobe and Jermaine Wiles own, Sean Calfrobe trains. Number 4, Get Moving, Eugene Weaselhead owns, Godfrey Weaselhead trains, Philip Clunas the jock. And your right is on number 5, Sold on Askra, Alvin Crosschild owns and trains. Number 6, Grapes of Math, Laris Ellen in the Irons, Judy and Norm Cuthbertson own, Norm Cuthbertson trains. And number 7, The Gov, Jack Bowen owns, Donald Cochran trains, Freddie Fuentes the rider. And number 8, Ruha Laho is aboard, Taking a Dip, Eric Turner owns, Harold Burbank trains. There's your field of 8, traveling 6 furlongs in 5 minutes, 5 minutes a post. And the horses are loading now for race six. On the inside, Awesome T out while Aikman Joe gets shuffled back a bit. Also moving up, Wily Willy Code alongside Get Moving. Outside from there now, Grapes of Math is getting some stick. Inside now, Aikman Joe. Back from there, Sold on Askra. Now coming up on the outside, it's the Gov. Up front with the lead, it is Grapes of Math and Laris Ellen right there. Get Moving is in second place. Third on the inside, Wily Willy Code on the outside. Fourth, the Gov. Back from there on the inside, Sold on Askra is trailing the field. And Awesome T is back from there. Also back is Aikman Joe. And Sold on Askra continues to trail. Quarter mile to run. Grapes of Math with the lead, but challenging now. Get Moving and Philip Clunas on the outside. In third place, it's the Gov. In fourth, you've got Awesome T now coming with some run. And back from there, Wildly Willy Code, followed by Aikman Joe. And trailing is Sold on Askra. Around the final turn, they come in down the stretch, and with the lead it is Grapes of Math heading for home. In second place, Get Moving. This battle might be for second or third because Grapes of Math has it wrapped up. 6-4-2. Gate the Wire victory for Laris Ellen. Judy and Norm Cuthbertson. Oh, Norm Cuthbertson, your trainer. Races number six, Grapes of Math, $3.90 win, $4 place, $3 show. Number four, Get Moving, wow. $52.90 to place, $15.40 to show. Number two, Aikman Joe, $3.10 to show. $1 super factor, 6-4-2 with all, $100.60. $2 exactor, $73.20. $2 try, $225. $0.20. Thank you so much. And there is the call to post for race number 7, exact your try to wagering, 6 furlongs in distance in this $5,000 claiming race. Number 1, Neville Stevenson up on Lucky Tomorrow, Jim DePew owns and trains. Number 2, Italian by Marriage, ridden by Ruhal Laho, Rocky Mountain Turf Club Stables own, Lyle Magnuson trains. Number 3, Laris Allen aboard Naomi's Gift, Lyle Magnuson owns and trains. Number 4, Baylock Orr, Scott Sturt, Gordon Haug owns, Gary Marks trains. Number 5, Street Preacher, Jody Jackson owns, Jim Christensen trains, Tim Moccasin rides. There's your field of 5, going to post in 6 minutes, 6 minutes to post. Number 5, Street Preacher, and we're good to go. We're at the post. And they're off on the inside. Lucky Tomorrow and Italian by Marriage right alongside. Then it is Naomi's Gift alongside Baylock Orr on the outside. Street Preacher. This is a 5 abreast field here as they come in front of the grandstand for the first time. On the inside, Lucky Tomorrow. On the far outside, Street Preacher. Inside from there, Baylock Orr on the inside of that, as well as Italian by Marriage. Trailing is Naomi's Gift in the early going. Up front now, Lucky Tomorrow rolls along. In second place is Italian by Marriage in the inside rail now. Naomi's Gift making a run back from there, Baylock Orr. And trailing is Street Preacher. Into the straightaway they go, Lucky Tomorrow and Neville Stevenson with the lead on the inside. Naomi's Gift, Baylock Orr up there as well. On the outside from that, it's Italian by Marriage, and trailing is Street Preacher. Up front now, Baylock Orr makes a move to come up and join Lucky Tomorrow. On the inside, Naomi's Gift is taking advantage of that rail opening. What a battle this is. Around the final turn they come, and down the stretch of Naomi's Gift with the lead. On the outside, Baylock Orr in between horses, Lucky Tomorrow. As they approach the wire, Naomi's Gift is rolling along. Baylock Orr in second. It is Naomi's Gift picks up the victory. We'll say congratulations to the winning connections. Number 3, Naomi's Gift, ridden to victory by Laris Allen. Lyle Magnuson owns and trains. Your price is number 3, Naomi's Gift, 1470. Win, 410 place, 260 show. Number 4, Baylock Orr, 620 place, 410 show. Number 1, Lucky Tomorrow, 320 show. $2 exactor, $37.80. $2 try, $91.30. And we have your attention. There was a claim in that race. Number 4, Baylock Orr, was claimed by owner Lloyd Buffalo, trainer Floyd Buffalo. Once again, number 4, Baylock Orr, claimed by owner Lloyd Buffalo, trainer Floyd Buffalo. things off. Scott Steer is on number one, Island Storm. Sean Lang, Dylan McConaughey owns. Gail McConaughey trains. Number two, Tithing. Les Webb owns and trains. Neville Stevenson rides. Number three, Got a Stash. Graham Hoban owns. Russell Gardepi trains. Tim Moccasin, your jock. Number four, Gents Little Lady. Andrew Wright rides. Justin Lawrence owns. Jess Menicky, your trainer. Number five, Closing Katie, ridden by Blanford Stewart. Andrea Peugeot owns. Nellie Peugeot, your trainer. Number six, Southern Echo. Pat Provo owns. Lloyd Wiesekase trains. Trevor Simpson on board. And number seven is Fourth in Command, ridden by Carlton Malcolm. Colleen O'Hagan owns. Mike Taphorn, your trainer. There is your field of seven fillies and mares going to post in 8 minutes. 8 minutes to post. And the horses are loaded, just about. Number seven, Fourth in Command, steps in. Now we're loaded at the post. And they're off. On the inside, Alan Storm out, shuffled back. His Tithing moving up now, Got a Stash. Center of the track, Closing Katie outside from there. Fourth in Command, now coming up the outside, Southern Echo. Tithing is back there, and trailing is Gents Little Lady in the early going. A half mile to run. Battles on up front on the inside. Island Storm right there. It's Got a Stash. These two locked up on the outside. Fourth in Command in contention. Fourth on the inside. Closing Katie in fifth place. It's Southern Echo in sixth. It's Tithing, and trailing is Gents a Little Lady. A quarter mile to run now. Up front, hanging on, Island Storm and Scott Steer. But on the outside, Fourth in Command. Coming with some run, back in third it is, Got a Stash in fourth place, Closing Katie now coming as well, Southern Echo from off the pace, Southern Echo is passing horses, bing, 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 up front, Fourth in Command with the lead, but Southern Echo is coming on the outside, down the stretch they come, Fourth in Command with the lead, Southern Echo looking to knock this one off as well, Southern Echo on the outside, Fourth in Command on the inside, as they approach the wire it is, hanging on, Fourth in Command. Southern Echo for second, 7-6. And we want to give a big shout out to Antoinette, who's been a part of our farmer's market here for years. Antoinette is pulling up stakes and heading to Ontario. So Antoinette, thank you so much for your lovely smile every time we see you, and good luck to you in Ontario. Right now, we'll say congratulations to the winning connections. Number seven, Fourth in Command, ridden to victory by Carlton Malcolm. Colleen O'Hagan owns, Mike Taphorn trains. And here are your prices. Number seven, Fourth in Command, pays $8.80 win. $4, place 310, show in second. Number 6, Southern Echo, 610, place $4, show. Number 5, Closing Katie, 460, show. $1, Super Factor, $176.80. $2, Exactor, $52.90. $2, Try, $183.80. Weighing in number 8, Big Buddy. And Big Buddy's in, and we are at the post. And they're off. On the inside, midst of chaos, out with more speed, genius level, guns out. General Day up there as well, right alongside Rose's Thorn out from there. Carson's Fireball and Big Buddy shuffle back now, midst of chaos, back from there, Dubla Gold, along with T-West. Half mile to run now up front. Carson's Fireball and Apango are battling it out with Midst of Chaos. In third on the inside is General Day. And then fourth now comes Midst of Chaos. Back in fifth place it is Rose's Thorn, followed by Genius Level, along with Dubla Gold, and trailing is T-West, a quarter mile to run. And Carson's Fireball and Apango continue to roll along. In second, you've got General Day on the outside. Midst of Chaos, there's your front group, several lengths back from there. Now Dubla Gold makes a big kick and starts to show some run as well. Into the final turn, and Carson's Fireball and Apango continue to roll along, and down the stretch they come. It's Carson's Fireball on the inside. General Day now comes up to capture the lead. Late run from Dubla Gold as well as they come to the wire. This one belongs to General Day. 3 and a photo for second.